Ron Meyer here with Young America's Foundation. I'm joined by Congressman Paul Ryan, the chairman of the House Budget Committee. Congressman, are either of the debt ceiling plans on the table right now, whether it's John Boehner's $1.2 trillion plan or Harry Reid's $2.7 trillion plan, acceptable to fix the problems with the debt facing my generation?
They won't fix the problem facing your generation. The question is, will we get a down payment? It is very clear, given that conservatives control one half of one third of Washington, with this president and this Senate, that we're not going to get the kind of spending reforms and cuts we need to fix this plan. So the question is, given the reality, the divided government we have, can we get a good down payment? I would also question the whole 2.7 of Harry Reid. That's really more than $1 trillion of budget gimmicks. So the question is can we get a good down payment of spending cuts? Look, it wasn't long ago the president was asking for more spending for this year. We got that taken care of. And now he's asking for a blank check just to go on this borrowing spree some more, and we're putting a stop to that. So we'll get a down payment, but we would need more change in our leadership up here in Washington if we're going to save it for not only just your generation, but for our economy today. In the old days of 2007, you know, we used to say the debt was a threat to your generation, my kids and grandkids. Not anymore. It's a threat to our economy today.
Well, yeah, I think we'll get to that too when we talk about the interest payments that are coming up
right.
Due. But isn't it sort of embarrassing that Harry Reid's plan's bigger than the one being proposed by the House right now?
No, because it really isn't. If you take a look at Harry Reid's plan, it's so much gimmicks. They basically have this gimmick where they assume that the Iraq and Afghanistan war will be funded at surge levels for a decade. And therefore, when they pull out of Iraq and Afghanistan, they save all this money, $1 trillion, and then at about $400 billion in interest. So it's really a huge budget gimmick. The Boehner plan, the $1.2 trillion are real spending caps, which gets you real cuts. They're not as much as I proposed, but they're real. And then they had this committee to get the rest of it, at least $1.8 trillion in cuts. And they had to be actual cuts, actually voted on by Congress. Now look, I proposed a budget to cut $6.2 trillion. So I think we've been really clear where we think we should go. But the Boehner plan is more real and actual versus the hollow gimmickry of the Reid plan.
Well, speaking of your plan, why haven't I seen you more involved in these talks? I mean, you're one of the leaders of the budget. I mean, especially for conservatives, we actually trust what you're doing. I'm not sure right now that we really trust the talks going on. Why aren't you in there more?
Because the elected leaders decided to do the negotiations. That means the Speaker and the Senate Minority Leader decided to take point in the negotiations. The reason I probably haven't been as prominent in discussing this in the media is because if I'm not in the room making the negotiations, I shouldn't be the spokesperson talking about what's being done in the room. It's just that simple. I never expected using the debt limit that we would get everything we wanted. I never expected that. I was hoping for a down payment on the problem. And you're not going to fix this country's problems until you get a new president and a better Senate. And it's just that clear.
So we were talking about, basically, we actually face a problem in the short term, which
right.
is the interest payments, really,
yes.
that we have to pay down on
That's
our
right.
debt. Are we going to have time to fix this if we even, you know, if things change?
I think so. I think if we get a decent down payment now, that ought to calm things a little bit. Even if we get a debt downgrade, which is quite possible in the near future, it's still not going to be too late, in my opinion, just talking to economists and the markets and others. But I think we have about 2 to 3 years before it gets too late. And that means we got to get as much down payment on cuts as we can right now. And then we need different leadership after 2012 to fully fix this problem. What we'll end up doing if we don't have structural reforms to our government, to our entitlement system, is we'll be like Europe and we'll just do a sequence of austerity measures. They'll all be quarter or half measures. They won't be sufficient. The bond markets will keep going after us. Our interest rates will keep going up, which is like what's happening in Europe. And we will enter what I call stagnation or managed decline phase. We need fundamental restructuring of our government and our entitlement programs if we once and for all want to get this crisis away from us and get our economy back to growing and give your generation, and I'm an X generation, my generation as well, a bright future in a prosperous economy.
Well, you're just talking about austerity measures that just kick the can down the road. Isn't that exactly what's being proposed
yeah,
right now?
Yeah, but that's what we have when you have a president who is so liberal and a Senate who's so liberal. Look, the president has put out a plan. He hasn't put out a plan. The president wants a blank check. He's to the left of Harry Reid on this debt limit debate. That just shows you how bad things have gotten.
Is he and Harry Reid, are they serious about this debt problem in your mind?
I think they believe we should just raise taxes. I think they believe that government's not big enough. It's on the right trajectory to get bigger, and all it is getting the public to get us to raise taxes to pay for it. We're not going to fall into that, but I think they really do believe that a government that's around 30% of GDP, we're historically 20, a government that's about a third bigger is where we ought to be, and it's just a question of going out and finding enough taxes to pay for it. And by the way, there aren't enough rich people, quote unquote, to pay for this. Every American will have to pay a lot more taxes if we're going to go down this path that they're paving for us.